Let's see what's happened if you want to trust the usual vital sign that we use in assisted ventilation, like respiratory rate and tidal volume. As you can see, with this pressure supersetting, we have a good and pretty evident diaphragmatic activity, but we have a little bit higher respiratory rate and the tidal volume that is quite low. So usually what we have to do, if we don't have EDI signal, we want to increase pressure super because we want to lower respiratory rate and to have a higher tidal volume. So we go up in 3 centimeters water steps. Remember that EDI is more or less 10 microvolts now. And let's see what's happened. The central respiratory drive response is very fast usually, so let's see in a few seconds what's happened. Nothing special, the respiratory rate is still high. Let's go up again. 3 centimeters water steps. Let's give the time to the patient to know that we are assisting her. As you can see, the diaphragm activity is less evident. We have 6 microvolts of EDI peak, a slower, a not so evident decrease in respiratory rate, and not a big augmentation of tidal volume. So I want to have a respiratory rate below 13, so 3 centimeter waters increase. An effective effort. A sigh. And then you can see almost complete diaphragm activity suppression. The EDI peak go down. You have a major asynchrony. This one is a timing asynchrony. This one is a timing asynchrony. You can see there on the flow curve. This one is timing asynchrony again. So, okay, this is the situation where we have a normal respiratory rate, a pretty normal tidal volume, above 6 ml per kilo, but no diaphragm activity, not at all. So this is a clear example of overassistance during pressure superventilation if you targeting just respiratory rate and tidal volume and maybe SpO2.